to have a final drink. For the road into the bottom of this league, you will go. I wouldn't be so damn arrogant if I were you. Let's see where I stand when all this is through. I can sense some jealousy right over there, but does it look from my face that I really care? Step up your game, my friend, and let's see. Can you compete with me?
Shame. Crying shame. Hot diggity doodah.
Hello, I'm John Paul and reporting for Bonjour TV. I'm reporting tonight from the North Chase West Bank campus where people are arriving to watch the... Where people are arriving to watch the premiere of Roast Pork and Beef... of... The Gangs of New Pork. No. Gangs and Roast Pork. North Chase's entry for the Observer and Guardian Postgraduates TV Drama Competition.
Pissed again, Leslie?
Of course not, old chap.
Is she coming?
Judy? Yes, of course. I think she should have been here by now. And Danny apparently is coming too. And when they arrive, I'll take them upstairs and...
Large lashings of shampoos on the department's budget?
We have Emma Parsons, the writer of tonight's film. Tell us, Emma, how excited are you about tonight's viewing of your team's finished product?
Well, I'm excited to see what unfolds tonight.
What challenges did you face during the production process?
Yeah, in any production there are challenges. The key is simply to overcome them. Every dog has its day.
What advice would you have for the budding TV professionals?
Well, you have to persevere and give it your best shot.
The judges tonight are the famed directors Jane Benfield and Rob Thorburn. Are you excited to meet them?
I think I'm going to be sick.
Thanks for your time, Emma. Best of luck to you.
Ah, Susan. So, is she here yet?
Holy Christ, have you been drinking again?
Judy and I go back a long way, back to my theatrical days. Oh, those days.
Yeah, those theatrical days.
She deserves a proper reception. Oh, God. What a cock up.
Look, please, just listen.
Susan, not now. I have two things to do. I'm busy. Not now.
Leslie.
Busy, right.
Oh, my God. Emma, what's wrong?
To freeze over. What do you think a bloody looks like, Susan?
Well, it looks like you're being sick, but that was going to be my second guess.
Leave me alone, Susan. Fed up with it all. This thing between us is as pointless as a microphone for Cheryl Cole.
Emma, what thing between us?
Oh, for God's sake. Shit actors, shit films, shit night. Three shits for the price of one.
I think the film's good. Look, I shouldn't really be telling you this.
What? You don't like me anymore?
What are you talking about? I still like you. I like the film. You've done really well.
You like me?
Of course I do.
So here it is. Merry Christmas. Everybody's having...
I'm so scared. I'm gonna look so stupid.
Look. Your drama is all right.
How can you say that? We get five world-famous actors in to save the day and lose half the footage because of Harry.
Emma, listen. About what I was going to tell you earlier. We're arranging a surprise for Leslie after the preview. Bobby? Oh, shit. Oh, no, sweetheart. Oh, you poor darling. Okay, I'm on my way. Gotta go.
Got a thing with Barbie now?
Don't be ridiculous.
How much is that dog in the window?
Oh, ha ha. Very funny.
Well, you barked up the wrong tree there.
Give it a rest, will ya?
You better rock it up her ass.
Maybe she's menstrual.
She's just come from the bathroom.
Well, maybe she's seen the reshoots.
What, and is about to throw herself off a cliff?
Well, they are pretty bad. You start with Judi Dench and Danny Craig, and end up with actors so hammy that they give Pork a bad name.
I thought you said Pork already had a bad name.
That's a stupid title.
It's not what you said to Warren on the shoot.
Children will believe anything you tell them. Still, nothing to do with me anymore.
Yeah, you took your name off it. Coward.
Well, now you're the producer and the director. Aren't you going to feel embarrassed?
That's enough now. Don't make me get the muzzle out.
Enough of the dog jokes already.
Pity the Dean didn't send you to Battersea Dogs Home. Could have been worse.
He saw the funny side. Eventually.
More than I did.
He thought I'd got my punishment. Broken hip?
Yeah, he was more pissed at me.
Well, you're the one who accorded over his star list actors.
I didn't know. It was Harry's deceit.
Of course you didn't. Miss Innocent.
You know what, Peter? You're the dog's bollocks.
Poor Bob.
Don't call Robbie.
I flattened. Leslie's pavlova. Sounds nasty. Taken a stupid pill this morning.
Hello, ladies.
What is this? Scene from a soft porn movie or something?
What is that on your face?
Don't even think it.
What?
I like your tux, Mirage.
Oh, I always wear a tux, Marvi. Kind of an eccentric tradition, if you will. But it looks like you've kind of upstaged me by washing your face in a jizz fountain.
Oh, disgusting! And to think I was going to ask you out for a drink.
You?
You think I want to go out with a plastic doll called
Don't
Barbie?
Don't call me Barbie.
They're telling you, Rog.
We'd like to thank the Daily Guardian for sponsoring this event. We are delighted with the way it's all turned out.
And your department will get £25,000 if you win.
Yes, yes, and three tickets to LA for the filmmakers. Very, 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 very gratifying. And we are hoping that our scriptwriter, Emma Parsons, will bring back gold. There have been media attention about the rumours of celebrities being involved, but let's just keep guessing.
No, there were some editing issues and I'm not sure if she's in it anymore. Well, any of them. They had a few glitches. I haven't even seen the final edit. Yeah.
Yes, that all sounds very interesting. Please carry on. So, something up?
just a bit of fluff on my sleeve.
Excuse me.
It's the Guardian, Michael. It's the Guardian. Quintessential.
I really need to speak to you now. Take him. I'm done.
You must suck up to these people, Michael.
Listen, they aren't coming.
Who?
Any of them.
Oh, I'm so disappointed.
I couldn't invite A-list bloody celebrities to a premiere of a film that they're not even in.
If it was legal to murder Harry Jans, I would have done it.
Yoo-hoo, Leslie!
Oh, fiddlesticks. It's the judges. Kill me.
You should meet my daughter. She wrote Gangs and Roast Pork.
I'd love to. It's a curious title. It's a parody of Scorsese.
I imagine. She's around here somewhere. Emma. Emma, over here.
What the hell is going on?
Emma, this is Ken Heathcliff from The Guardian.
I've seen that girl before.
Ken, this is my daughter Emma. Emma, this is Ken. He's a journalist from The Guardian.
Good to meet you. From what I've heard, your dad's very proud of what you've done.
Oh, hello. It's nice to meet you too.
So, how do you feel about the show?
A little bit nervous. I'm not sure how completely...
Oh, don't be so modest. This drama is going to be a success. Look at the numbers. I must say, it does take a very different approach to mainstream drama than the usual audience is used to.
Are you confident that you're going to win the competition?
I'm not too sure.
Of course she will. Like I said before, there will be parts that on the surface look weird. But when you think about it in a different light, it is fantastic. Therefore, we might as well give her the prize money and plane tickets now and stop wasting everyone's time.
Okay.
Hiya, Pete. Dogging days are over then.
You've got some nerve showing your face around here.
I have every right to be here.
Tell Leslie James that.
Leslie? He's too pissed to notice. Besides, I left Joanna. He didn't kick me out.
So, who invited you?
I assume my invite got lost in the mail.
You're unbelievable. You're the single only reason that tonight's going to be a disaster.
Yeah? Maybe it is. But you and I both know that without her father, none of it would have been like this. So I think it's small justice that those A-list scenes will not be shown tonight. And I've come to witness everyone's disappointment.
Here you go again, stirring up trouble.
That should be me being interviewed.
And there was me thinking that men didn't suffer from midlife crises because they were stuck in adolescence. But clearly, you're still just a child.
Says you with your petty little revenge scheme.
Whatever, Harry. Haven't you got any more films to sabotage? Go on, skedaddle.
You must be joking. I'm here to enjoy everyone's humiliation, including yours.
What the hell is going on? What do you think you're doing?
I'm just clicking.
Why are you touching her?
If you just let me explain.
It's nothing like that.
Why are you yelling?
Well, it looks like that.
Pull yourself together.
Seriously, what's going on? Why have you got cream all over your face? Oh, is this another sexual fetish? Seems to be a lot of that in this drama.
Emma, would you relax?
How can I relax when you're two-timing me?
It's nothing of the sort. I'll explain later. I can't deal with your irrational jealousy right now.
Considering the pressure she's facing. Yeah, that was too far.
Are you right to finish yourself off?
Thank your part. Oh, I'll manage. Thanks.
I bet you feel really proud of yourself, don't you?
What?
You're loving this.
Loving what?
It should be me taking the credit for all of this, not you.
What are you going on about?
The only reason you got the role of scriptwriter was because of him.
Because of who?
Don't play dumb with me, Em. I'm fed up with this crap.
What is up with you, weirdo?
You're what's up with me. You and your dad.
Okay, you're acting really crazy. I've had enough, Harry. You're pissing me off now. I really don't need this.
Well, this needs to be said now.
Harry, what is your problem? I haven't a clue what you're talking about.
I know about your dad funding the project. Your father schemed to get you this job.
You what? Are you accusing my father? My dad didn't get me the job, Susan did.
Susan? Why would Susan get you the job? Why would she pick you over me? Everybody knows I'm the better writer.
Susan got me the job, are you not listening?
Why would she get you the gig?
Susan got me the job because she loves me. There, I said it. We're in love.
What are we doing here so early?
I've got to get the cripples in first.
Well, this looks like it's going to be easy.
Hey, take it easy. As you can probably tell, Stairs and I aren't the best of friends at the moment.
I have a good idea.
Well, just pack it in.
Oh, shut up before I push and let gravity have a go.
Just take it easy.
Girls got to have some fun, Pete. You could always get out and walk. Oh, I forgot.
What?
Can't teach an old dog new tricks.
No.
I cannot believe what just happened. God, sometimes I could just scream.
Are you all right? Do you want to talk about it?
Yeah. I'm loving the fact everybody knows now. I feel great.
I was only trying to be friendly.
Yeah? Well, you can stick it with
it. Yeah, okay. I know. Shove it where the sun don't shine. Yeah, got ya.
I don't want any of your sexist comments, that's for sure.
Look, Susan, it's not a big deal, right? Everybody knows, right?
Not that I was having a thing with a student. Not that I am. I was about to. God, I don't know.
It's not a big deal. I was getting a hummer in this very room off a second year the other day. She was nodding like a dog on a parcel shelf. It's fine. Don't worry. It's just a bit of fun. Calm down. Talking of fun, what do you reckon about this?
We should have told them.
Where's the fun in that? I've enjoyed seeing their pain the last few days. You've seen how nervous everyone is.
Sadist. How did you find it anyway?
Well, a funny story. I was looking on the system, you know, as you do, and I realised that some ballsack has put it in completely the wrong folder. I mean, cock.
Takes one to know one, Rog.
Every detail of my life, but you can't tell me you're funding the film I'm making. I've been humiliated.
Sorry. We haven't done anything, only kissed.
You've kissed? She's a lecturer, she's much older than you.
Not that much older. Do we really have to do this now?
How long have you known that you're
A what, Dad?
You know,
Dad, you can't say the word lesbian. It's 2013, for goodness sake.
You'd think that being an agent, you would be used to homosexuality. You're so liberal professionally, but not for your own daughter. Hypocrite. Why didn't you tell me that you were funding the film?
Because I knew how you would react. Everyone would think you got the writing job because of me.
But I did get the job because of you. Thanks a bunch, Dad. Still, given the crap that's about to appear on screen.
Don't worry about it.
You have such a broad vocabulary.
Thank you. Thank me.
Not used to talking in pubic, public.
It gives me a great honour to host this prestigious event. And our Observer Postgraduate TV Drama Award.
I think I'm going to be sick.
Don't worry about it.
Oh, God.
It's with a sense of achievement that my students have created a unique, perhaps master plan piece. There have been rumours of guest cameos. Now, rumours are just that. Rumours are rumours. Without further ado, Gangs of New York. Yes, well done.
I can't stay for this.
I'm surprised. Did you find what you were looking for?
Oh my God.
Yes. Good. I assume you have no regrets.
I don't. What about you?
Of course not.
I told you did really well.
Did you know the film had been restored?
Yeah, Roger told me.
I can't believe you didn't tell me.
Yeah, well, I was about to, but Barbie had just gone 10 rounds with a pomegranate pavlova.
Pavlova? What's she doing fighting with a ballet dancer?
Don't worry about it.
I know. It's catching, isn't it?
Wish I could help.
Oh, fucking believe it.
Good job, Rog.
He liked it then.
Rog, you kept that quiet, you bugger.
Up and push, Jana. Up and bloody push. It's not rocket science.
I'll push you back down in a minute, you needy little prick.
You love me, really?
I can't believe you put us through that.
Barbie, what did you think? Impressive, aren't I? How about that drink now? Now your face is a jizz-free zone.
Firstly, don't ever put any of us through that again. And secondly, my name's not Barbie! Hi. Yeah, I'm just running the bar. How are you? You're kidding me. You're kidding me. You can't be serious. Susan, you cannot be serious. We did. Oh my God. God, Dad! Dad! We won! You ever hear that story about the Emperor's new clothes? Where the tyrant thinks he's wearing a very fine coat and everyone goes along with the pretense because they don't want to contradict the experts. Until a kid says he's not wearing anything at all. There is nothing there. Same with our drama. There was nothing there. But the judges thought it was so original, they convinced all the panel that it was worthy of Stanley Kubrick. I suspect Dad and the celebs had something to do with it. Well, I know Dad did. Still, Leslie got his 25 grand. Puts me in mind of the art world where works go for silly money because some critic has decided it's a work of genius and everyone goes along with it. Still, who am I to complain? We got a trip to LA, Joanna, me and Barbie. Joanna's still there. She met an actor who reckons he can help her out. Yeah, we took Barbie, bless. Well, Peter couldn't go. He was shooting a promo for Battersea Dogs Home. Anyway, he took his name off the credits. Barbara, changed her name. She and Ken hit it off and they're an item now. She couldn't live with Barbie and Ken jokes, so she changed her name to Kathy. Unfortunately, Ken's surname is Heathcliff, so she better watch out. We all know what happened in Wuthering Heights. Harry? Last I heard of Harry, he was working in a bar called, appropriately, The Last Post. He's still hawking his scripts around, but no one's biting. Rog is still terrorising students. Susan and I didn't go anywhere. She got a job at the Royal Television Society. And anyway, it turned out I was the worst lesbian ever. Got a fella now, James. He works for Dad. Dad, of course, got me a literary agent on the back of us winning, and I'm now embarking on a writing career. Who knows? I'm under no illusions. We won because Dad is bankrolling the Guardian and Observer's competition next year. So it turns out, as usual, it's not what you know, it's who you know. Plus ça change, plus c'est la même chose.